sister.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Today we will learn about our first chapter. That is the world of
animals.
Have you studied about it?
Yes, sir.
So let's revise it. In this chapter, we have classified the animals in according to their properties, their habitat, according to their feeding ways, different ways. In different ways, we have classified the animals. Okay, so we will learn one by one. So first one is habitat. What is habitat? Yes.
The place where an animal goes from commonly is called.
Very good. And down. The place where animals grow or found naturally, यानी को naturally freely जहाँ पर रह रहा हो, वो क्या है उसका habitat. क्या है उसका
habitat
जो के different होते हैं, तो उसके according ये animals भी वहाँ पर different पाए जाते हैं. Habitat change हो जाएगा तो animals survive नहीं कर पाएंगे. Mostly जो से animals survive नहीं कर पाते हैं. एग्जाम्पल देखते हैं एलिमेंट्स के, फॉरेस्ट, डेजर्ट्स, ओरिजिन, ओशियन एंड लेट्स सी सम एग्जाम्पल.
यस सर.
ओके, दीज आर फॉरेस्ट.
यस सर.
डेजर्ट.
यस सर.
ओशियन.
यस सर.
दीज ग्रासलैंड एंड वुडलैंड, दे आर टाइप्स ऑफ
forest.
Types of
forest.
Ocean is different from wetland. How? Ocean have lots and lots of
water.
But in wetland, water is in less quantity. That means there is muddy water. What is that there?
Muddy water.
Water available in small quantity में, थोड़ा है, ठीक है? और उसने एक ऊपर एक layer बनाई हुई है, ऊपर रहता है वो कहीं normally लार्ज एरिया पर होता है. जैसे हमारा काफी हम देखते पानी में इकट्ठा होता है तो काफी ज्यादा लार्ज एरिया पर होता है, तो हम उसको बोलते हैं वेटलैंड. क्या बोलते हैं?
वेटलैंड.
अगर फॉरेस्ट में होता है तो वो हमारा वेटलैंड बन जाता है. उधर वेट वाटर ज्यादा है, सोइल के ऊपर एक वाटर की लेयर है, तो उसमें डिफरेंट टाइप के प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स होंगे. जो हमारा फॉरेस्ट है उधर डिफरेंट टाइप्स के एनिमल होंगे. जैसे एग्जाम्पल हम ले चुके पोलर रीजन का. पोलर रीजन पर जो है कोल्ड काफी ज्यादा होती है, एक्सट्रीम कोल्ड होती है, तो उधर कैसे एनिमल मिलेंगे जो उधर रह सकते हो, एक्सट्रीम कोल्ड को उनके अंदर सरवाइव कर सकते हो, ठीक है? पोलर बियर एग्जांपल लिए पेंगुइन, वो उधर सरवाइव कर सकते हैं, वो डेजर्ट में सरवाइव नहीं कर सकते. जो डेजर्ट में सरवाइव कर सकते हैं जैसे कैमल, वो पोलर रीजन पर सरवाइव नहीं कर सकते. तो एनिमल्स जो होते हैं वो अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर हैबिटेट ही वो सरवाइव कर सकते हैं. तो इसलिए हमने क्या किया, हैबिटेट्स के अपने उनको डिवाइड करा हुआ है. क्लियर है? नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, बॉडी कवरिंग. देयर आर मेनली फोर टाइप्स ऑफ बॉडी कवरिंग, दैट इज फेदर, फर, स्किन एंड सेल. लेट्स स्टडी अबाउट विद एग्जांपल. दीज आर फेदर्स. फेदर्स आर मेनली फाउंड इन बर्ड्स. वेयर? Birds. On. Okay. Now then fur. Fur is found in cold areas, in extreme cold. For example, with polar bear or in on sheep, we can see in air that is sheep contain, sheep have fur. Okay. Then scale. Scale may be found in on reptiles and amphibians, mostly reptiles. Cell also found in the, for example, tortoise cells. These body covering, they are used to protect themselves. These are used to protect them from different conditions. For example, fur is used to protect from cold. Cell is used from protect them by different danger like some insects or some other carnivorous or omnivorous animal. Okay. So according to this body covering, the animals have four main things, that are feather, fur, scale and
shell.
Next one is feeding habit. You have studied about feeding habit. According to feeding habit, we have divided the animals into different parts. For example, herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, carnivorous, and herbivorous. Okay. Herbivorous are those which eat only
plants.
What about carnivorous? What they eat?
Plants.
And about omnivorous, what they eat?
Plants.
Okay. So let's talk about scavenger and decomposers. Scavengers are those animals which eat dead bodies. What they eat? Dead bodies. They mainly contribute themselves to clean the environment. They help us in clean the environment by eating dead bodies. Okay, but they eat dead bodies. Scavenger can be the part of carnivorous or omnivorous. Scavenger can be the part of carnivorous or omnivorous. But there is a slight change. Carnivorous can eat other animals by killing them or their dead bodies. But scavengers mainly eat dead bodies like vulture. They also can hunt other animal, but they eat mainly dead bodies. They also help us to help the environment to be keep clean. Next is decomposers. Yes, but
the
well, decomposers, what they do, they convert the dead bodies of other plant or animals into compost or some organic matter and mix them with soil. Okay, they convert their dead bodies into other organic matter and mix in the soil. They are decomposers. Now let's study about next topic, that is breathing organ in animals. There are mainly three breathing organs. Like example, spiracles. For example, spiracles and holes are present on skin. It is, can also be named as skin because spiracles and holes present on skin. So skin and spiracles are almost same. Spiracles, gills, and lungs. That animal that have spiracles, they have their body. They can use their body to breathe. Aquatic animals have gills to breathe, and the animals live on land can use lungs to breathe. Okay. Now the next one is movement in animals. Yes. Movement in animals. Why animals move? Animals move to get food, for shelter, for water, for their other works, and for to keep them protected from danger. This movement is called known as locomotion. What is known as
locomotion?
There are different things that they use. They move for food, for shelter, to be get protected by different danger. This is, they are known as locomotion. Like in picture, we can see that these animals are getting air to drink water, and some are even crossing river or some that pond or etc. That jo bhi hai. ठीक है. Next, migration. What is migration? Migration is also movement of animals, but according to the season. The main thing that matter is season change. What is season change? This is done because of the change in season. Because of
season.
Like there are some places which in all year they are cold, but during winter the cold will be extreme. So animals from there or some birds move to some hot region to survive that extreme cold. Okay, this is called migration. What is called?
Migration.
You can see these animals are moving. These animals are moving. These are moving for food. For
food.
Because in the previous region, food is not sufficient for them. So they move to the new place to get more food to survive. Okay. Now let's watch a video.